There was a time when the Yippies stood for the Youth International Party, and they were an organic coalition of stoned-out hippies and political activists who found that they had more and more in common, like the same drug dealer, same arresting officer, the same defense attorney. And the hippies got more involved in political activism, and the political activists got more involved in having fun and discovered that fun and responsibility were not mutually exclusive. So the Yippies didn't have a big budget to protest the war in Vietnam. And so what we did was have guerrilla theater activities that would get free publicity, because if you give good quote, you'll get free publicity. For example, when there was going to be a demonstration at the Pentagon, it was decided that there would be an exorcism of the Pentagon. And the Yippies went to Washington and had a meeting with the Pentagon people and had an agreement that they could not raise the Pentagon more than 3 feet above the ground because they didn't want to hurt the foundation. So this was a trick that we borrowed from the CIA, which is you don't have to manipulate the media if you can manipulate the events that the media covered. So we went out there and had a press conference, and the reporters did their job. They just took down notes on what was said, which was they say that we can only levitate the Pentagon 3 feet above the ground. So they wrote that down, and that was what was printed in the paper. And that served as an organizing tool, because a lot of people decided to go to the Pentagon to see it levitate. Another thing that was done was Abby Hoffman invented an imaginary drug called Lace. Lace was supposed to be a combination of LSD and DMSO, which, when applied to the skin, was absorbed and would serve as an instant aphrodisiac. So Abby and Anita Hoffman called for a press conference at their apartment on the Lower East Side of New York, and they were going to have mattresses spread on the floor of the living room, and there were going to be three hippie couples that were going to be sprayed from a water gun with Lace. It was actually a novelty item from Taiwan called Shapiro's Disappearo, and it would come out purple on the skin, and then it would kind of disappear. And I was going to be there as a reporter, and Abby said to me, we want to spray you accidentally as a reporter, and there's this lovely redhead who will be there, and we're going to spray her accidentally, and then you're going to put your reporter's pad and pen down and disrobe and start making love with her on the mattress. The whole point of this was that they were going to say that Lace was going to be sprayed on the National Guard and the military police at the Pentagon. And so I was ready to go to see that. I mean, even people who were for the war were going to go just to see that happen. And so I was kind of excited about this. Even though the sexual revolution was at its peak, there was still something exciting about having a blind date and knowing you were going to get laid. But then I went home and checked my schedule, and there was a conflict. I was scheduled to speak at the University of Iowa that same day. There was a literary conference. So Abby said, well, look, why don't you get some cornmeal? There's a lot of farms in Iowa. Then we can encircle the Pentagon with it as a pre-levitation rite. So I was supposed to be a rationalist, but it was very hard to say no to Abby. So I got to Iowa, and Robert Stone was there for this conference, the novelist, and he drove me to a farm. And I asked the farmer, I said, I'd like to get some cornmeal to go. And he said, coarse or fine? And I looked at Bob Stone, he said, well, it's for a magic ritual, I think this would be coarse. So the farmer says, okay, coarse, how many pounds do you want? And I said, 13 pounds. And so he kind of looked askance, he said, okay, he didn't even charge us. And so I was able to come back to New York from Iowa with a 13-pound sack of coarse cornmeal stored properly in the overhead rack. And it was indeed circled around the Pentagon for the pre-levitation rite. But while I was gone, the guy who they got to substitute with me, who got accidentally sprayed with Lace, ended up living with the beautiful redhead that also got... And even though I had never met her, I felt jealous. I felt I had been cheated out of a romance by my schedule.